I'm Michelle Reed, the superintendent of Fairfax County Public Schools, and I am having the most fun ever this morning. I am with our Oakton High School robotics team, and they're an incredible group of young people, and we are here today to answer the eternal question everyone asks in math class: when are we ever going to use this? So I'm really excited to be able to hear what first brought you this excitement or interest in robotics.
Yeah, so something that drew me to robotics is that obviously when we build a robot, we have to solve a lot of problems, and that's like one of my favorite things to do. I love figuring out ways to take a physical solution and apply it to a problem that you can have, and also the way that like the physical components of the robot will combine with the programming elements to create something that can actually do things in real life. I can see like that is very applicable in the real world. And it just got me really excited for stuff I can do in my future and fun I can have right now in high school.
So as team captain, what are the responsibilities? How heavy is that mantle of leadership? Because I understand it's got to be tough. So what are the special requirements, you know, to be the team captain here?
Yeah, so it really just involves making sure that the build and programming sides have communication between them, right? If we need to program the new bot, we need to make sure that the build team can give us, you know, whatever pieces we need to program on time. And so as captain, I sort of have to make sure everyone is sort of aware of what's going on, right? The programming team might be like, oh, you know, where's our robot? But, you know, the build team has like other issues that they're running into. And it's just good to make sure that everyone understands what each team has to tackle, so that there's also like some forgiveness that each team can give each other, right? It's just very important to establish that communication between both teams.
So one of the things that I was really excited about and shared earlier this morning is that we're really moving higher level math into lower grades. Mm-hmm. And we're really thinking about in the coming year offering algebra, for example, in sixth grade at many of our elementary schools, eventually at all of our elementary schools, at least the opportunity to take algebra in sixth grade. What do you think about that as students now in high school and successful roboticists, I guess?
I think that's really important and probably really useful as well. I know for programming, we use advanced linear algebra and advanced physics, and having a head start on math allows you to jump into physics and advanced math further. Even in programming, in both build and programming, trig is really important. We use something called vision, where we have a camera that reads little QR codes on the wall for us. And that involves a lot of trig, as we have to calculate stuff based on the distance and like the offsets that we would have. And I think having a head start onto trig would help people get more like into the field. And I know fields such as like machine learning and AI are like coming into the picture now, so having trig experience would be really useful.
I definitely know that math can help like streamline the building process. You can use like basic trigonometry to help find where holes go, and like it really just makes it easier, so you don't have to go through the pain of like setting something up when you can just use simple math to get to the solution that much easier.
Triangles and like trigonometry in general is extremely important for basically everything. If you think about everything here, it's either a circle, a square, or a triangle. I think that's one big lesson I've taken away from robotics.
It goes back to your example up here, the circle.
Another great example is these two things. They're a little bit poorly made because I made them on the fly, but basically when we're in the game, these press against a kind of wall there.
Right.
And even though they look like a square, actually when they're pressing against the wall.
Oh, they're actually a triangle.
Yeah. It's triangle on that side. Right. So like that just kind of goes off the idea. Everything is a triangle.
Right.
And I think that like being able to know what to do with triangles, how to find, you know, the base, the height, the area, blah, blah, blah. And that kind of thing is all just going to be very important for everybody's lives.
I feel like, at least from my experience, like in elementary school, I saw like not only me, but a lot of my friends also wanted to be able to progress in math and further like their math careers. However, they didn't have the opportunity necessarily to kind of carry out that interest. Yeah. And they ended up having to take like classes over the summer to get to the level they wanted to get to. And I think it's a great opportunity for people to be able to kind of start early.
No, I think that's awesome. So who can take a math fact for me this morning and show our entire community? I mean, who doesn't love math? but show our entire community sort of how that math idea actually translated into this. And I think we've got our volunteer here. So let's talk us through it. Why do we need to learn this math now?
Okay. As you can see, this is all pretty complicated, but I just want to focus on one small thing. If you look right here, this is just a little belt that drives our flywheels. So the belts are fixed length, and we know the size of our pulleys, but we want to know how much space we should put between this shaft and this shaft to make sure the belt is nice and tight. Because if it's loose at all, it might slip, it might fall off. That's a whole host of issues we want to avoid. So when we're approaching this problem, what I'd like to do is I just kind of draw it out. It looks pretty complicated, but it's really just two circles and a rectangle in the middle.
Right.
And then using our geometry skills, we can find the length of it and make sure that this is nice and tight so that this can spin and capture our little coral piece. For me, it's almost like I don't really consider it as doing math because it's almost just like, automatic. Yeah. But looking back, math is extremely important to everything we do here.
Yeah, I just think that for all of our students, mathematics is important. And obviously, you're not worried about graduation requirements. I mean, you've exceeded them already, I'm guessing. But it's just so important because I think, as you talked about looking around the world, you see patterns everywhere and design elements, right? So do you think you learn more from failure or success?
I definitely think from failure. I think it's been like, it's like that in everything, not just in robotics. When you try something that you think will work and you have ideas for what it's supposed to do, and then it ends up not working, you learn from that, and then that way you know what works in the future. So
It's so interesting because our system so often is built on not
getting
being
it right
able to
the
acknowledge
first time,
failure
right.
and getting it right the first time, right? And so often perfection gets in the way of progress.
Definitely.
So, I just want to thank you this morning. This has been probably the best part of my week. Really appreciate it. So I look forward to seeing what you do later as you graduate and move on and transform our world. So always know your very biggest cheerleaders are here, and we want to have you check back in with us. So, you bet. All right.